Hello, I'm Indy, and welcome to part 19 of my Doom Pistol Start playthrough. This is Mount Erebus, and it's a pretty difficult map. I'm not really for a pistol start. As you can see, we already have a lot of ammo and a shotgun. So that's not really the biggest issue here, but it's a tough map nonetheless, and it has a secret exit, which is pretty tricky to find, but we're not there yet. We'll get there at the end of this map. It's the first map in the Doom franchise that features such an open map. As you can see, it's a very open area with a couple of buildings that you have to explore. It's a kind of map you see a lot more in Doom 2, to be honest. This building has two teleporters, so let's take the right one first. Gives us the plasma rifle, also releases a couple of Kako demons. Let's go into the left portal here first, and then deal with these Kakos. Might as well use the plasma rifle for it. There we go. And yeah, the best way to deal with this map is just methodically clear everything out. So we'll just enter this building next. Yeah, the open area is surrounded here. Ooh, that's a lot of lost souls. It's surrounded by let's just leave them for now, with lava, but there's a lot of radiation suits in this map, so that's not really the biggest issue here. Okay, let's pick up the Berserk pack here just in case we encounter a lot of demons. And I think behind these candles we have secrets. Yes, that's right. Okay, let's get that chain gun. Can we drop in there? Yes, we can. Gets us inside another building. And by now I have released a lot of monsters outside, as you can see. Because it does appear that every time you enter a building, a smaller building in the lava opens up, releasing a lot of monsters, but they are in fighting right now, so they'll clear themselves and themselves a little bit out, so that always helps. Another pretty interesting thing about this map is this key, which is located after that secret there. Not sure what that did, but we'll figure it out. But in on easier difficulty settings, that key is just laying in the open of the map, in front of a building. That's one of the very few occasions that the difficulty settings changes something in the map itself instead of enemies. Okay, let's see. We found 3 out of 4 secrets now. And the final secret is the secret exit. And to be honest, when we picked up that chainsaw a minute ago, we were very close to that secret exit. Let's first get rid of all of them with the plasma rifle. Let's hope we have enough bullets here, or plasma, I should say, cells. Okay. We do have to keep an eye on our health here, because it's dropping very, very fast. Okay. Let's just enter that brown building here. I think there's an entrance somewhere. There we go. Just see if there's another med pack here. There is. Can't say I like the fact that there are so many geckos in this map, and I don't really have a lot of cells left, and I don't have a rocket launcher yet, so I'm not a big fan of that. We might as well pick up this suit here. And while we're having the suit, we might as well explore the lava a little bit and look inside these little areas that opened up because I entered buildings in the center of the map. I'm not sure if you can see it, but there's a small little blue rectangle there, a blue room. If you can drop in there, that's the secret exit, but it's not not very easy to drop in there. Let's pick up the map. And get rid of all these enemies, and then we'll have the rocket launcher as well. To be honest, I'm not the biggest fan of these open maps in Doom. I prefer the more smaller closed-in ones with good level design, but this one is probably one of my favorite open maps. We'll not pick up that invincibility yet because if I remember correctly, you best keep it for the secret exit. Let's find a new building to enter. Can I get into this one? Let's get rid of these enemies first. Now that we have the rocket launcher, I might as well use it. There's a lot of monster closets in this map. And they're not really filled with my favorite enemies, but... it'll work anyway. There we go. Ooh, I'm in trouble. Let's see, I am gonna go pick up that supercharge here, there we go. Gives us of course 100% health again, or very close to it. Of course what I meant was it gives you 100 health points, but in this occasion it got me close to 100 health. Okay, let's enter this building. I think we're getting pretty close here to the end of the map. Let's get out our rocket launcher for that Baron there. There we go. this is why I find the Kekko so annoying. If you don't have rockets or plasma cells, they just take a long time to kill. But they're not really hard enemies at all. Okay, as you can see, one more secret, one more enemy. And I think I'm gonna pick up a suit here and pick up some armor just because we can, not because we need it. And yeah, all we need to do now, I think, is find the exit and that final enemy. Maybe one of the enemies is just floating around as well, so that would be annoying. I can hear him. This is the normal exit, so we'll not be taking that one. Now, where is that other enemy? It's to my right, I think. There he is. And of course, it's another Kekko demon. There we go. Well, that was it for all the enemies. We need to get to the secret exit now, and that is annoying to get to. We need to go back to that building with the two candles where the secrets were behind. I think it was this building right here. Yes, it is. Then go in the portal. Okay, here we are. There you can see the switch, the skull switch there. That's the secret exit to this map, but it's really, really tricky to get to. And yeah, just for the sake of this playthrough, for the sake of this video, I'm gonna make a little quick save. So basically, this is the only thing left we have to do here. But I, yeah, don't want to go around to get to this point each and every time I screw up, because this is a rather tricky thing to pull off. Okay, what you have to do is either strafe jump in there, just running and strafe, if you just strafe run diagonally running, so you run into the square there. The reason that works is strafe running makes you run just a little bit faster than normal running, but the intended way of doing this is standing right in front of it, turning around, and shooting a rocket. As you have noticed, that's a problem since I don't have any rockets left. So we'll have to try the strafe run way. This is pretty tricky to do, as you can see. So what I'm going to do is look around for another rocket if I miss it. And I will demonstrate as well how you get out of this area if you screw this up. So let's just try this strafe running. That was actually pretty close. That doesn't work. Then you just go around there, go into the portal, and we're basically gonna hope that we can find another rocket somewhere. And there is one right here. That's good, so we can demonstrate the intended way of doing that. So we need to go back into this area on the portal, and like I said, watch straight at the skull switch, turn around, and what you want to do is yeah, it's kind of like a rocket jump in Quake. You want to run backwards while you fire the rocket, and it will push you into that area. There we go. That's how you do it. It's pretty tricky to pull off. You see, I lost some health doing that. That's because that's not the perfect way of doing it. We encountered a couple of invincibility spheres, I would say, the green balls. And what you're supposed to do is pick one up and do what I just did, so you don't get hurt as well. So, pretty tricky to find this one. And that's the end of Mount Erebus. I hope you liked this video, so leave a like, comment and subscribe. And I'll see you next time for the secret map. Goodbye!